your hands, everybody. Come on.
Presenting Mrs. Dorothy M. Nixon, 6th Episcopal District.
I'm sorry, will you please stand now and... great pleasure to present Mrs. Sharon Pickett.
Thank you very much, Ms. Scott. The presentation of the 1990 class of debutantes and masters is about to begin. Our commentators will be Ms. Lubesta Davis, St. Paul AME Church, Vidalia, Georgia, and Ms. Juanita Harris, St. Mark AME Church, Athens, Georgia.
With great pride, it is my pleasure to present Christy Vanderbilt of today and tomorrow. The son of Mrs. Bonina Perry, the nephew of Dr. and Mrs. Aubrey Clifton, a member of First AME Church, Athens, Georgia, the Reverend Claude Ray James, the pastor. He attends a set of shows regularly. He's a member of U.S. Army ROTC. Son of Ms. Cosina Rogers and Mr. Arthur Johnson. I now present Mr. James T. Larson, the son of Reverend and Mrs. James Larson. He is a member of St. Luke AME Church, Athens, Georgia. Reverend James Larson, the pastor. He's a student at Cedar Shores High School. James' interests are football, basketball, and track. I now present the young Christian gentleman, Mr. Marcus D. Ricks, the son of Mr. and Mrs. Butler Sharpton, Florida, and the Gospel Choir. He enjoys playing football, basketball, and running track. I now present the young Christian gentleman, Mr. Braxton R. Britton. Stop, Mark. His major goal in life is to invest in the young Christian gentleman, Mr. Ellis Brown. The son of Mr. and Mrs. James Brown. He's a member of the Principal's Honor Society, Student Council, French Club, Arrive Alive organization, basketball team, track team, and the Jackson County High School Band. Mr. Ellis Brown.
The young Christian women of the Church of Alpha. I present the lovely Miss Tamara Bowles, daughter of Mrs. Romeo Bowles. Tamara is a senior at Tamara is a member of the First AME Church in Athens, Georgia. Reverend Claude Ray James Pastor. She's a member of the youth choir, youth usher board, junior student board. She's vice president of the local YPD and second vice president of Augusta Athens. She attends Clark Central High School, where she is a member of the student council and second. Daughter of Mr. and Mrs. James Jones. Chandra is a member of First AME Church in Athens, Georgia. Reverend Claude Ray James, pastor. She is active in YPD, youth choir, debutante, and masters.
We will now be favored by our solo, Ms. Lynn Munford, Greater Bethel LB Church, Athens, Georgia, followed by the significance of the occasion, Ms. Carol Hansley, St. Paul LB Church, Vidalia. Impact. This program is significant because it commemorates the first It makes manifest the fact that fellowship and social grace are incomplete and unworthy of note without the more lasting virtue of spiritual grace and development. This program is significant because of its interdenominational acceptance. Since 1952, tens of thousands of young people have celebrated their rite of passage into adulthood in church-sponsored venues. The Roman Catholic, the Episcopal, the United Baptist, the Presbyterian, the Congregational, and other currently church-sponsored venues are adaptations of and attestations to the merit and value of the AME Christian Debutante Master Dedication. Perhaps this program is most significant because it represents milestones in the evolution of a socially conscious and socially relevant Christian ministry. Let us never forget that this contribution to contemporary church life is an African Methodist Episcopal contribution. To AME's Mrs. Juma Brown Crawford and Reverend Joseph Lawrence Roberts for their inspiration of the idea, we must extend ourselves in gratitude. Endorsed in February 1953 by the Council of Bishops of the AME Church, widely copied throughout the Christian world, witnessing the needed addition of spiritual grace to social grace, and adding the keystone to the arch of a socially relevant ministry, the church-sponsored debut first presented as an AME Christian Debutante Master Dedication Service is now a part of Christian history. But the past is always prologue. The present and future significance of this dedication will be determined by you, to the extent that you, the adult church, will allow it to relevance in the lives of Christian youth today.
Peace. certainly we would ask you to be as liberal as possible. I am going to ask that as many as came, as a matter of fact, to give $10. I'm going to give 10, and I'm asking all those who came to give $10.
Ministers-wise, the DMC, and all other organizations in the state of Georgia. For Dr. David Hamilton Jackson, Associate Administrator of the DMC from the 6th Episcopal District and the Pastor Stuart Chapel AMB Church, Macon, Georgia. With the host presiding elder, Dr. Uzi Grant, the host pastor, Dr. Claude Ray James, the DMC Commissioner, Mrs. Andrew Thomas, the Associate Elders, ministers, the 1990 class of debutantes and masses, the Alanite sub-devs, and all my brothers and sisters in Christ. I greet you this afternoon. I first want to extend my sincere thanks and appreciation to each of you for making this program a success in this conference. We've only been in this conference for 3 years. We've covered a milestone, and we have a lot more milestones to cover. I'd like to say to the honorees here this afternoon, and to us adults as well, as they make the transition from adolescent and young adults to adults, let us be sure, let us be very sure, that they are fully equipped with the necessary tools and equipment to function in an adult society. Let's take for a moment here and think about the ocean and all of its ugliness, and all of its self-destruction, raging waters, pollution, despair, but yet in its calmness, you can see the beauty, relaxation, food, serenity, exercise, and jobs. I remember as a child growing up, I was told our Heavenly Father did not make any junk. And I believe that today, some of us just turned into junk. So young folks, young adults, subs, Alanites, don't turn into junk. That's my thought I need to do today. The recognition is presented to you in behalf of the people of the city. Thank you so much.
Gentlemen were handsome, and the girls were just lovely. And I am so glad I poems which were cited by the mistress of ceremony as these young people came up. Engineers and all sorts of other kinds of jobs and positions and aspirations. And I think that, most of all, what it said to me was these young people know that there is no limit to what they can do. And she was introduced by the wife of the President of the United States, Eleanor Roosevelt. And I was very young, but I remember, and I don't remember what Mary McLeod Bethune said, but I do remember what her opening remarks were. She looked at the graduates and she, this little woman with a big voice said, "You're all dressed up. Now where are you going?" And every time I come to one of these, I look and I go to commencement, I think, "You're all dressed up. Now where are you going?" And as I look at these young people come up there today, you know, you look at them in those gorgeous white dresses and you think, is it a wedding? Is it a prom? Just what is it? But they're all dressed up. And I wonder, where are they going? I don't know where they're going, but I can tell you one thing that I'd like to leave with them. First, I want to say one thing to one aspirant, and that was the young man who said he was going to be a millionaire before he was 30. All I have to say to him, that he will be out of black Donald Trump, and I don't have any problems with that. I just want him to remember that 10% of that belongs to the Lord. Young people, may I leave with you the scripture, "Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all other things shall be given unto you."
I'm senior bishop and the African Methodist Church and presiding bishop of the 6th Episcopal District of the African Methodist Episcopal Church. To Dr. Donald Isel Adams, the Episcopal Supervisor of Missionary Society, the minister's wives, and the honorary mistress of ceremony, to Mrs. Dorothy Nixon, DMC Commissioner for the 6th Episcopal District, to Mrs. Annie Ruth Thomas, the DMC Commissioner for the Augusta, Georgia Annual Conference, to the presiding elders, to the pastors, to the parents, to the friends, to the Allenites, to the sub-devs, sub-masters, to the debutantes and masters, to my brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus the Lord. I hope I missed anybody. I'm just happy to be here, and first let me say I'm happy for quite a few reasons. On yesterday, it's a very special occasion happened in my life. Tallahassee, Florida, my son, David Hamilton Jackson, Jr., graduated magna cum laude. He went a little ahead of his father. I graduated cum laude. When I was at Allen University, Dr. Fitzpatrick said this. He said he was around, and when he graduated, he started crying. Someone asked him the question, said, "Now, why are you crying, Frank?" And he said, "I'm crying because I didn't graduate cum laude." The fellow looked at him and said, "Let me tell you something. If I get out of here, oh Lordy." As I look at these young people, I'm very proud. I'm quite sure not only are you going to graduate magna cum laude, but you're going to graduate summa cum laude. Also, my son was inducted into the AFRICAF Review National Honor Society. He is going, he's already been accepted at Florida A&M graduate school to go work on his master's and say he's going to work on his PhD. Now, I think that's because of his training and something that my wife, what we did together, caused him to want to do things like that. Also, on Mother's Day of this year, my daughter finished, Belinda finished Tuskegee the first semester of 89. She teaches at Pitts Elementary School in Atlanta. But she will march on Mother's Day. So we're proud of her also. Now I'm proud of all of you, and I'm quite sure that as I listen and You said what you were going to do and what you're going to be. You know what get me today is that we make too many excuses. You know, we need to stop doing that. I wouldn't do this, but somebody said, well, it is true. We have drugs in America. And say, we don't have the planes and the boats to bring them over. That's true. But you know what? You do not have to take them, and you don't have to sell them to your people.
Amen.
You see, that makes it a difference because you have my share. You don't have to use them. And I'm saying to you, young people, first, you are Christian. Second, you are Methodist. And third, you are Methodist, or you're members of the African Methodist Episcopal Church, and you are special. God bless you. Jackson, parents, men and women of the hour, class of 1990, debutantes and masters, visitors, friends, welcome to historical First African Methodist Episcopal Church. We greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I'm glad to see all of you. And I'm glad for this opportunity to say some words of wisdom because the debutante of the Augusta, Georgia annual conference began here at this church in the annual conference in 1988. And it is always good to see an idea that one has developed grow and it is growing. And just one word of wisdom, and that is I hope that all of us will continue to support our young people. If we don't, who will? And if we don't do it now, please tell me when. I beg you to support them in their effort to do good. You know, we chastise them when they're doing bad. So today they're doing good. Let us support it in every way that we can. Thank you so very much, and God bless you.
To the 6th Episcopal District and the Master Commissioner and Associate Commissioner, to the Augusta Conference Commissioner, to all the local conference commissioners, reverend clergy, presiding elders, and pastors, to the very distinguished parents and grandparents. I always used to say parents only, but about 4 years ago when I became a grandparent, then now I realize how important they are. Having grandchildren is so much fun. I've been trying to figure out how to have grandchildren without having children. But I decided that wouldn't be no fun because I wouldn't have nobody to give them back to. To the Debs and Masters, and I must say you are a lovely group of beautiful and talented young women, strong and handsome young men. My, what a joy it is when we hear so much negative about our young people to see this remarkable sight this afternoon. I salute you to the Alanites. Aren't they the cutest thing you ever seen in the world? I'll tell you, I'm so proud of y'all, y'all. And I've never seen that many youngsters behave so well. I think you ought to give them a hand. That age, about in this much time, I would have had 7 fits and 7 spankings to the sub-dibs and masters, ladies and gentlemen. I'm very pleased to be here, and I'm very, very, very impressed with this group of young people who are your dibs and masters this year. I was noticing, like Mrs. Adams, their aspirations and intentions for their lives and how well they have chosen. It was Dr. Benny Mays who said that the sin and mistake in life is to aim low.
Amen.
And I want to honor you for not aiming low, but aiming high. And those of you who are going to be teachers, I expect you to eliminate illiteracy on the face of the earth. Those of you who will be systems analysis and engineers, I expect you to find a way to deliver viable housing to the homeless and deliver the abundance of food to the hungry. To those of you who want to be lawyers, I expect you to let justice roll down like the waters. And those of you who intend to be doctors, I want you to find cures for the incurable diseases. The Lord's name be praised. And in addition, Mr. Millionaire, not only do I expect you to give the Lord 10% your tithe, there's absolutely no point in having that much money and not do something redemptive with it. So I want to suggest to you now that you put on your agenda to build a building named in your honor on the campus of Mark Brown College.
And brave and
and you can become whatever it is you want to do. So in the future, when the diseases of my old age have eroded my health and well-being, I'm going to come to those of you who are their doctors, and you better have something to cure me. And when I get in deep trouble and need a lawyer to straighten it out, I'm going to look at those of you who have become lawyers, and you better get your fertile legal mind to work and set me free again. Tradition of Richard Allen and Henry Manuel Turner in the African Methodist Episcopal Church, expect great things. Yes. Go do it.
Jefferson Board. We, the former Jeffersons, in fact, challenge and commit their faith and love to the wholeness of the human spirit and the improvement of the world in which we live. Open their eyes that they may see thy work yet. Remain in attune their ears to that still small voice crying out in the ghetto. Train their hands in the labor of kingdom building. Guide their feet toward the path of righteousness and consecrate their hearts in compassion for their fellow men. In the name of the Spirit of our Christ, we do pray. Amen. Let us repeat the Lord's Prayer together in unison. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory, forever.
Thank you. dying to ask.